Hey everyone, this is Soren, and I'm here to show you a new audio effect that I've been working on. It's called the time lag filter. So I'm going to open up here. I'm hosting it in Reaper, which has been very helpful for development on this plugin, because when it crashes, which it has very often in development, as I'm sure most software does, you can, since it's running as a bridged plugin, you can just close the plugin itself. It doesn't have to shut down Reaper and close your project. I can just make my changes, recompile, transfer over the DLL, and reload it. I don't even have to close the program. So that's very helpful. The program is made using the Juice application framework, which is a set of C++ libraries. This is the little IDE for Juice projects here. It's a set of C++ libraries for it's intended for audio plugins, among other things. I've used it for everything from particle physics research to a program for some custom file format editing, and it's been very helpful. The GUI stuff here you can do very easily with a it has a built-in GUI editor here. Obviously, you have to put in the functionality, and any custom components like those graphs you have to make from scratch. But that comes with the territory with something like this. So anyway, this time lag filter it's technically an LTI, linear time invariant system, though its effects are drawn out in time to an extent that it sounds like it's a time varying system. And of course you can change any of the parameters and that is time varying then. So the way it works is the core of the filter, which is represented by this box in here, is a bunch of all pass filters chained together. So in this case, there's 128 all pass filters, second order all pass filters. So that makes a 256th order filter. Each of these filters is implemented with IAR, of course, because you wouldn't want to do 256 times the coefficients necessary for one FIR filter. They're all pass filters, so their amplitude response is flat. Their phase response is not flat. So the phase response for one filter will look something like this. This graph here is what the phase response will look like for one filter, except this is 128 of them. And right now, all of the filters have the same center frequency and the same bandwidth. You can see what those parameters are here on the graph. Center frequency is that, the center motion of that center there, and the bandwidth is how sharp that edge is. I'll talk about this graph in just a moment. So this is what the phase response of a single filter would look like. And since there's 128 of them with the same parameters, this scale is simply 128 filters. You can see it goes up to 120 or 128 here. It's just a phase lag of 128 times 2 pi, which is would be the phase lag for one filter at high frequencies. So you'd think, okay, so who cares? Why would you know, if it's a flat amplitude response, our ears don't really hear phase, so, you know, why would we care about that? Well, the thing is that if you think about it, if the phase delay is so long that it starts being a time delay, then that delay will be audible. Now, it's a little more complicated than that because if you put in a single sine wave and the phase delay is, 300 or 500 or something like that, it's still a single sine wave. It'll be just the same as if there's no delay. However, if you put in a transient, which contains a lot of frequencies, or you put in a sort of a bump of near one pitch, which is actually a bunch of frequencies near that pitch, that each of those frequencies will have a phase delay that's slightly different from each other. And if it's at a place like this where the change in phase delay over frequency is very high, that is the derivative of this graph, which is graphed here, the group delay. So at those frequencies, the group delay, or rather the actual delay in time of that wave packet or of that transient, will be this long amount. This is unitless at this point. It's just sort of an arbitrary scale. But this is quite a high amount, and I'll show you what this all sounds like in just a moment. So the idea is to take certain frequencies and delay them in time. So it's like a delay, like a traditional delay in some ways, but it would be like you took your signal in the frequency domain, delayed each of those frequencies by a different amount of time, and then put them back together. This is something I've never seen before. I have seen all pass filters. The only place I've seen all pass filters used in audio is in a phaser. And you can make this act like a phaser. I'll show you. Just turn the filter number of filters way down, make it like four filters, and then mix in some of the input with the filtered output, and you get your phaser. But this, for the normal use of this filter, there isn't any feedback. There isn't any sort of, except within each IIR filter itself, there isn't any feedback throughout the filter chain, and there's no mixing of the original signal with the filtered signal. So let's do some audio samples here. I'm going to start out with a synth sound, and I'm going to turn off the time lag filter here. So this is just a little Moog emulator synth here playing a simple pattern. And this is without the filter. And so now I'm just going to turn on the filter. Let me put this back to its sort of center parameters. I'm just going to enable the filter. Now, I'm not sure how audible this is through YouTube with the audio compression and everything, but what's going on here is in the right channel, we have the dry signal from the left, from the original dry left channel. And in the output left channel, we have the wet, the filtered signal. And the input going to the filter is 100% the left channel. So basically, this is only taking the left channel, and it's putting dry in your left ear, dry in your right ear, excuse me, and wet in your left ear. Should be able to hear some, a little bit of delay and also some like kind of noises. And I'm going to change some of the parameters and make that a little bit more intense. I am going to also vary the parameters in just a moment as the sound is playing. You hear that lingering on that note? That's because at that frequency, there's a very high group delay here. So I'm now going to start messing with the parameters as it's playing. Again, only keeping, you'll see here in just a moment, I'm just changing all of the filters the same. So there's still 128 identical filters. I'm just changing the parameters of all of them at the same time. Now, if you hear, it's doing a pitch shifting result as well, and that actually comes from the fact that the whole audio signal is delayed through this whole set of filters. Although it's not recording or playing back at faster or slower speeds, these are just the, in effect, the center and bandwidth, or if this was a band pass filter, it would be the, you know, the band frequency and the bandwidth. Obviously, a lower bandwidth here is a higher resonance. So there's no, unlike a chorus effect or something like that, it's not actually recording and playing back at different speeds or different virtual speeds, anything like that. It's still going through the same filters. It's just that the filter parameters are changing as the audio goes through. Now, I can set that up. Obviously, you could hook this up to a modulation graph here, a parameter automation. However, right now in the current beta version, The parameter ranges, I don't have it set up with the ranges correctly. So the ranges that Reaper knows about is just 0 to 1 for all the parameters. And here the parameter is 10 to 12,000. So that just, it'll just set it to some value between 0 and 1, and it'll work, not work. So for now, I can't use that. But in the eventual release version, that will work. So we can change the filter parameters over filter. Now, this is more of the kind of thing that you just have to play with. I've been able to get some interesting sounds out of it. I haven't found a really major thing that you can do with this that you couldn't do with fixed frequency, but, you know, it's an extra control, and there's a lot of controls, and this is the kind of thing that you put on a synth, or you put on, well, to use it in this state, you would put it on a synth or something like that and get some, you know, interesting sound out of it. So, you know, play with the sound, and there you go. So let me set these both as linear. They can be linear in either direction, of course. Let me just start playing here. So you see now, it's not just picking out a single frequency and making that delayed, it's taking a range of frequencies. Now the delay isn't as much, but for the same amount of filters, you'll sort of get the same, you'll get the same area under this curve, because the integral of the derivative is the original function, or the average of the original function, and then this function will always have its average right in the middle. So so let's try something else here. I have a logarithmic preset here where it goes logarithmic that way or that way, and try a couple other things. I'm also going to try it with a different sound. So this has been the synth sound. I also have a guitar here. This is one of the East West plugins. I don't have any humanization or anything. It's just a sort of an ordinary guitar sound. Another one that this is going to be a little bit more pronounced with, these are some drums from a low-end sound font here. You can hear the transients very well on the turning into this kind of sounds. You hear how that clap has sort of turned into a whoosh. Another thing you can do here is you can set one of either of these graphs to custom, which means they become disconnected from these parameters and you can just draw on them directly. This is more of a gimmick than anything else, as you might expect from a feature like this, but it's interesting, and if you come up with some shape that you really want to see, you can draw it. So, yeah. A word about these graphs here. This is being calculated from a theoretical model of the continuous time versions of all these filters. So this, if this was actually 128 filters implemented in hardware, as, you know, with op amps and resistors and capacitors, and they were ideal components, then this would be the phase delay and group delay. The thing is, this is not continuous time system. This is discrete time system, but it was easier to model the continuous time system for the sake of calculating the group delay and everything. This isn't putting a frequency in and actually getting a response out. It's showing you what that would be. So it's an approximation. I mean, this is that kind of an effect. This isn't an effect that's intended to be, you know, really sample accurate. I mean, it is sample accurate, obviously. It takes one sample in and spits one sample out, but it's not intended to be that kind of thing. In any case, it is what it is. I'm going to go back to fixed frequencies here and show another aspect of this. So this is running 128 filters right now, but you can take the output from any filter in the chain. This says modulatable, but if you just jump between them, you're just jumping between filter outputs, so there's going to be discontinuities. I don't have a solution for that right now. Maybe I'll put in some sort of filter, you know, smoothing filter on those discontinuities. Not sure if that'll really help, but for now, it's a very easy way to just change, hop around, and see how things sound. So with the current parameters, you can hear that sort of those sweeps of tone in the frequencies. So I'm going to turn down the number of filters being used here, and you'll hear how it changes. So by the time that we're here, the output just sort of sounds not filtered at all, and it isn't. Now I have the right channel with the full original amount and the left channel with the wet signal here. But you will hear that this is still, those filters are still working if I make this actually like a phaser. So the original signal and the wet signal will be in both channels now. That's a little loud, and this isn't sounding quite as good as I was hoping here. Let me just change that bandwidth. Now, there we go. Let me try that with that synth sound here. Yeah, so there's your phaser. It's not as intense maybe as a phaser might be, but that's because I don't have it hooked up to a crazy LFO sweep that goes through the whole range. One more thing to mention, this does support actually changing the number of filters being run. So I can turn it down, of course. Let me make this, you know, 15 filters. The graphs respond in all the ways they should, and it still works. There's that phaser we were doing, but in this case, you can't really get anything too insane in terms of the delays, because it simply doesn't have enough filters to put the signal through. There's not enough opportunity for delay. You'll hear that there's maybe a little bit of phase difference between the two ears, but it's not terribly pronounced. You will hear, though, if I start mixing in different phase versions of the input signals here, you definitely will hear phase differences, but this isn't anything special. This is just messing with the mixer. So yeah, all of the mixer knobs go from positive 100 to minus 100, and to invert the phase. And that can make kind of interesting. Interesting sounds there. But anyway, let's reset there for that a second. And yeah, so I can turn this down, of course, in terms of the number of filters. If it's taking too much CPU, which hopefully it won't be, this machine is 8 cores at 4 gigahertz each with 32 gigs of RAM. And with this, it can do 128 is what I've been doing as the default. the process actually running this is this Reaper Host 64. It's a 64-bit plugin. Right now it's using only 1% of CPU. I did do some run the optimizer on the code just before I record this video, so it's nice that it's using very little CPU. So I was able to turn it up before to 512 without really killing things. It still says only 2% CPU. Let's see how it goes. Hear all that delay? That's great. And let's see, so it's still like 1 to 2% CPU. Okay, let me really crank this and see what happens. So I'm gonna do 1024 filters. So this is 1024 second order filters, or a 2048 order filter. The group delay is getting pretty high here. You hear when I stop it, there's a little bit of, it's still playing the delayed signal, and then it gets a little weird before it stops. I think that has to do with the floating point. It goes to denormalized numbers for the very, very low numbers. I'm gonna look into that, see if I can disable denormalization for this thread, but since there's different threads, it gets pretty complicated. Anyway, let me crank this because I'm gonna try 2048 and see what happens. The CPU usage is only 5%, and again, that's 5% out of 12% because there's 8 CPUs. So that's about half of one CPU running at 4 gigahertz. It's crazy. It's sort of not even recognizable anymore. Let's hear how this sounds with the percussion. Wow, you hear that delay? So here's with some drums. Meow, meow. That's so cool. And with our guitar. Sort of starting to sound like handbells. CPU. Okay, this is not good, but this is not good. I'm gonna stop that right now. Okay, so we were able to get. Is it not working anymore? Did I screw something up? Okay, I think it bugged out. Sometimes what happens if you get into a illegal state, that array holding all the sample data for the previous filters, if that gets sort of out of range, if it gets saturated, then it'll just saturate all the filters, and no matter what input you put in, it'll remain saturated. Once it goes really nonlinear, it stays nonlinear. So, maybe 4096 is a little too much. 2048, I'm very glad to see that worked, and I hope you find this interesting. There'll be a link in the description. Currently, this is just a beta version, so no promises on it working well. But it is—it's a VST3, 64-bit Windows version for now. Juice does support multi-platform, so there should be AU sometime. But I don't really have a Mac, that has this kind of audio tool chain to compile that, but we'll see what happens with that. In any case, I hope this is interesting. It's GPL licensed, so download it, try it out, use it in your stuff. If you make something cool, please let me know, but you know, no obligation, and enjoy.